heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground. When he got up from prayer, he came to his disciples and found them sleeping because of grief. And he said to them,
"Why are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you may not come at the time of trouble."
While he was still speaking, suddenly a crowd came, and the one called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them. He approached Jesus to kiss him, but Jesus said to him,
"Judas, is it with a kiss that you are betraying the Son of Man?"
When those who were around him saw what was coming, they asked,
"Lord, should we strike with the sword?"
Then one of them struck the slave of the high priest and cut off his right ear. But Jesus said,
"No more of this."
And he touched his ear and healed him. Then Jesus said to the chief priests, the officers of the temple police, and the elders who had come for him,
"Have you come out with swords and clubs as if I were a bandit? When I was with you day after day in the temple, you did not lay hands on me. But this is your hour and the power of darkness."
And they seized him and they led him away, bringing him into the high priest's house. But Peter was following at a distance. When they had kindled the fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat among them. And a servant girl, seeing him in the firelight, stared at him and said,
"This man also was with him."
But he denied it, saying,
"Woman, I do not know him."
A little later, someone else, on seeing him, said,
"You're also one of them."
But Peter said,
"Man, I am not."
Then, about an hour later, still another kept insisting,
"Surely this man also was with him, for he is a Galilean."
But Peter said,
"Man, I do not know what you are talking about."
At that moment, while he was still speaking, the cock crowed. The Lord turned and looked at Peter. Then Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will deny me 3 times. And he went out and wept bitterly. Now the men who were holding Jesus began to mock him and beat him. They also blindfolded him and kept asking him,
"Prophesy, who is it that struck you?"
They kept heaping many other insults on him. When the day came, the assembly of the elders of the people, both chief priests and scribes, gathered together and they brought him to their council. They said,
"If you were the Messiah, tell us."
"If I tell you, you will not believe, and if I question you, you will not answer. But from now on, the Son of Man will be seated at the right hand of the power of God."
"Are you then the Son of God?"
"You say that I am."
"What further testimony do we need? We have heard it ourselves from his own lips."
Then the assembly rose as a body and brought Jesus before Pilate.